Hi, my name is Ruth McKee and I'm an assistive technology practitioner with Columbia Regional Programs. Today we're going to do the programming for a step-by-step with Levels Communicator. The step-by-step with Levels Communicator is a great tool for students with complex communication needs. However, it may not be intuitive to program. Let's look at the two different versions of step-by-steps that Columbia Regional Programs carries. The older version is named Step-by-Step with Levels Communicator. The newer version is called Step-by-Step with Levels. However, we'll be concentrating on the programming today of the older Step-by-Step with Levels. Let's practice by putting in a joke. First, we're going to turn the device on. Then we're going to put it on the appropriate level. Let's use level 1. Next, we're going to press the record button until the light illuminates. Then we can speak our message while holding the switch top. How do you know when it's time to go to the dentist? When I'm done with my message, I release the switch top. When I'm ready to do my second message, I hold the switch top again. 2:30! Now let's do a second message on level 2. And hold the switch top while I speak my message. I pledge allegiance to the flag and release after the first portion of my message. Again, I hold the switch top to the United States of America. When all the programming of the Pledge of Allegiance is complete, I would press and hold the record button until the light goes out. Now let's listen to our programming.
How do you know when it's time to go to the dentist? 2:30.
And on level 2?
I pledge allegiance to the flag.
Remember, if you want to change one of the messages, all of the messages will need to be re-recorded. Let's take one more look at the back of the Step-by-Step with Levels Communicator. Here we find two ports. The first port is for ability switches, like the ones we have here. The second port is for the use of toys or appliances. The appliance or toy will run for the duration of your message. If you have difficulties programming your Step-by-Step with Levels Communicator, replace the 9-volt battery in the bottom of the device. Let's review the key points of recording a Step-by-Step with Levels Communicator, which is the version that generates the most questions. First, turn it on. Then slide the level indicator to level 1. Press the record button until the red light appears. Press and hold the switch top and record your message. Continue by pressing and holding the switch top to record additional messages. After you're finished recording all your messages in level 1, slide the level indicator to level 2. Repeat the same process on level 2 and level 3. When you're done programming all your messages, press the record button until the red light turns off. You are now ready to listen to your recorded messages on the different levels. Remember that when you're using the older Step-by-Step with Levels Communicator, that all levels must be recorded at one time and in sequence. Once you have recorded your messages, you will not be able to simply record one message without re-recording all of the messages. Additionally, we talked about two ports on the back of the device. The first port is where you can insert a student's ability switch, and the second is for a toy or appliance, which allows you to activate a battery-operated toy or appliance for the length of the recorded message. Finally, if you have difficulties programming the Step-by-Step with Levels Communicator, the first thing to do is to replace the battery with a fresh 9-volt. We realize it can be difficult to program the older Step-by-Step with Levels. We hope that this video clarifies your questions. If you need further help, please contact us at the regional office.